Now, it's time to discuss about sequence-to-sequence model. Before this, you must know about RNN, LSTM, or GRU that we have discussed before. What is sequence-to-sequence model? In this model, we convert sequence in one domain to sequence in another domain. For example, if we are doing language translation from English to suppose Hindi, then first domain will be the sequence of English language, whereas second domain will be the sequence of Hindi language. So, sequence-to-sequence model, or in short, SEC-to-SEC model, is used for several projects like machine translation, speech recognition, video captioning, question answering, chatbot, text summarization, and many more. We have already discussed about LSTM and GRU. Then why sequence-to-sequence model? LSTM or GRU map each input vector to their corresponding output vector. That means, for each input, there will be corresponding output. But suppose in language translation, when we want to translate English language to Hindi, the length of the input and output may not be equal. Suppose if I type, "What is your name?" Length of input and output are same. But when I type, suppose, "How old are you?" This time the length of input and output are different. Clearly, we can't use a regular LSTM network to map each word from the English sentence to the Hindi sentence. To deal with this problem, or to solve many more complex problems, we have sequence-to-sequence model. This SEC-to-SEC model uses the concept of encoder and decoder. This model encodes our input vector and decodes the output vector. This is the very simple architecture of sequence-to-sequence model. What is inside this encoder and decoder? Encoder and decoder can be LSTM or GRU models. Look at this architecture. What do you see in this architecture? In this model, we have two main part, that is encoder and decoder. And between them, we have encoder vector. The task of encoder network is to understand the input sequence. And I have already mentioned, this RNN can be LSTM or GRU. Each RNN accepts current input and previous hidden state. Then this encoder produces a final vector which we call encoder or intermediate vector. Remember, in this SEC-to-SEC model, each input didn't get mapped to their corresponding output vector. So, there will be no any output in each RNN network. This encoder only gives final encoder vector, which is then passed to the decoder. And based on the encoder vector, decoder produces the output. In this way, encoder-decoder sequence-to-sequence model works. Did you get it? I hope yes. Possibly in coming days, I will bring one project using sequence-to-sequence model. So stay tuned with this channel. Like this video, give me feedback in the comment section. I will meet you soon. Stay safe and keep learning.